In our last video, we looked at the design of our 5 1/4 inch driver. And now we've ordered the parts, they've been produced, they've been brought in. And now we're gonna take a look at each part that will go into the 5 1/4 inch transducer and why the design was chosen the way it was for the materials. The frame or the basket of the speaker is the part that all the other parts attach to. We attach the magnet assembly to it, we attach the cone, the spider, everything gets anchored to the basket. This particular basket is made out of a stamped steel material with a powder coat finish. This small part is a terminal strip, and it's made out of two parts. It's made out of a lug, and it's made out of an insulator board. The lug is used to attach the lead set that's going to be connecting to outside the woofer. The lugs on this particular board are 0.205 inches wide by 0.02 inches thick. This part is part of the magnet assembly. It's called a T-yoke, and the T-yoke gets its name from its shape. It's made out of a cold forged low carbon steel material. It has a zinc plating. This particular yoke has a hole through the center, which is a vent, which is part of the thermal management of the speaker. Our next part is actually the magnet of the speaker. This is made out of a ferrite material or a ceramic. This has a particular grade, which is a Y30 grade material. It is, at this point, as you can see, it is not magnetic. We won't charge this magnet until the very end of the assembly operation. The next part is the front plate, also called the top plate. The front plate is made out of a stamped steel, low carbon steel material. This particular plate is about 6 millimeters thick. You'll also notice that there are these four nubs on top, and these are used for attaching the front plate to the basket. In fact, those nubs are what will attach the entire magnet assembly to the basket. This is the voice coil. Now, the voice coil is often thought of as being the heart of the speaker because it becomes an electromagnet and actually is what causes the motion of a loudspeaker. This coil is made out of copper wire. We have 31 gauge wire. There are four layers of copper wire on this coil. And it has a resistance, a DC resistance, of about 6.5 ohms. The wire is wound onto an aluminum form. The aluminum is a great heat dissipator and is also part of the thermal management of the loudspeaker. This is the spider of the speaker. The spider is the compliant member of the speaker. It helps to control the resonant frequency. It also keeps the voice coil stable and moving in a linear fashion. This particular spider is made out of a cloth material that's treated, and it's actually a fairly stiff spider. Because this is going to be a high excursion woofer, we want to keep the voice coil moving linearly. Our next part is the cone. This is actually made out of two pieces. There's a Kraft paper body. It's actually a combination of Kraft paper and abaca fiber. It's very stiff. So that it won't flex during operation. The second part of the cone is the surround. This particular cone uses a polyether foam material, which is very, very compliant, but also very, very light, so that we're balancing out the moving mass of the driver. We want to keep more of the mass in the body and less of the mass in the surround. You'll notice two eyelets that are inserted into the cone. We do that, and we'll see that as we build the speaker, that becomes the attachment point for the voice coil wires and the tinsel leads that will ultimately connect the voice coil to the audio source. This is a gasket. This will go on top of the cone. It's made out of a plastic material on the backside and a compressible foam material on the top side. If this woofer is ever mounted to a baffle from the rear, this foam will help to create a seal around the speaker. The next part is a very, very interesting part. This is actually a wire. It's called tinsel wire. And tinsel wire is notable because of its flexibility. There are four strands of copper wire that are wrapped around a Kevlar core. It's flexible, even though it's conductive, because if you think about how a speaker operates, this speaker is going to be operating at somewhere between 50 and 100 cycles per second. And if you think about the life of a woofer, this tinsel wire will have to bend millions and millions of times, and we want to make sure that it doesn't fatigue. This is the dust cap. Now, the dust cap is actually part of the diaphragm assembly, and it mates with the cone. It covers up the voice coil area so that no debris gets inside the voice coil. It also is part of the moving mass. Now, this part looks large, but it's actually fairly lightweight. It's made out of a craft material plus a glass fiber to make it stiff. The entire mass of this particular dust cap is less than a gram. Lastly, we have another gasket. This is also a compressible foam gasket that will go on the rear flange of the basket. And this is used when we front mount the woofer into our enclosure. This will help create a seal around the woofer so we don't get air leaks. So all of the air exchange is happening through the port. So now we've seen all of the parts that go into making this particular 5 1/4 inch woofer. In our next video, we're going to assemble all of these parts into a finished driver to produce our 5 1/4 inch subwoofer.